Bautista saying last weekend in Barcelona that he was expecting some of his fan club, very well-known fan club as well, that Bautista has to be making their way to Jerez this weekend. And hopefully for Bautista, he can go on to have a strong result over the course of the three races here in Jerez. We're just watching Eugene Laverty here. Now, Laverty hasn't changed much in terms of position over the course of this second session. He's up in P11 at present, but he has managed to close the gap further still. And over the course of this free practice too, he's got well and truly within a tenth of a second now of teammate for the weekend, Michael Vandermark. That's an excellent effort from Laverty.
Yeah, only a thousandth of a second slower than Vandermark in this session. Round about a tenth of a second slower overall in the combined times, but that's really competitive from Laverty. Exactly what he needs to do, and it's going to give him a lot of confidence to think, you know what, I'm going to have an opportunity to be the lead BMW this weekend. Got to try and do that, because that's what's going to give him an opportunity to be on that bike next year, or at least on the Bonova bike next year.
Yes, absolutely. There is an opportunity for Eugene Laverty to remain on the World SBK grid for next season. The discussion point is as to whether that will be with the satellite BMW team, i.e. maintaining his contact with BMW. Of course, that's the reason why he's been brought in this weekend, because he's the obvious choice, having effectively lost his ride to RC Squadra Corsa, hitting problems midway through the campaign. So BMW have a rider on the sidelines, and a rider of the class of Eugene Laverty, who's had the success he's had around this circuit as well. There is no better choice. Just over 3 minutes remaining in free practice to Toprak Razgatlioglu, making his way out of the pits. So he's going to go for a late flying run, as are the others at the top of the time sheets. Michael Ruben Rinaldi and Jonathan Ray looking good on their latest laps. And Ray in particular, 0.2 of a second up at the halfway mark on his latest lap in free practice two. Rinaldi will be the first of the two of them to get to the line. That is, if he gets to the line, the way he's pushing on in the latter stages of this flying lap.
Yeah, impressive stop from Rinaldi, though, leading the way by 4 thousandths of a second on the combined times, and he looks set to be able to improve his time as well. Just seeing there Pisani with a technical issue up at turn five.
Michael Ruben Rinaldi then the first of the two big guns to get to the line. It's 1:40.283, so that bit of a moment for Rinaldi, losing him time in the second half of the lap. Jonathan Ray surely will improve. He's a third of a second up after three completed sectors, making his way through the final turn now. Jorge Lorenzo hairpin on towards the start finish straight. 2 minutes remaining in free practice two. Jonathan Ray surely will go fastest here, and it's the first sub 1:40 of the weekend. It's a 1:39.671. That's a stonking effort from Jonathan Ray, just a thousandth of a second away from being 0.4 of a second faster than Michael Ruben Rinaldi. So Jonathan Ray laying down a marker. You can see the gap he now has in hand over Rinaldi, Haslam, Bautista and Lowe's.
Yeah, he's laying down a marker. Toprak, though, has just finished his outlap, so we're about to see what kind of times Toprak's able to come in with in this session as well, whenever he tries to go for his time attack. So Jonathan Ray's put down a marker. Let's see if Toprak's able to answer it.
Bit of a dress rehearsal for the Super Bowl session, you fancy this. Jonathan Ray has, of course, had the vast majority of them this season, pipped in Barcelona last time out. In fact, not only by Toprak Razgatlioglu, but also by Tom Sykes, who was the pole sitter at the Catalunya round. Loris Baz up and running on his final stint, and that's a new personal best of this session, 1:41.138. He's run wide at turn one, and he may well not get another lap either, because we've only got 1 minute left in this session. Now, this is Scott Redding. He's set to improve on what he's been able to do in this session so far. Toprak Razgatlioglu, that's not the case for him. He's 0.3 of a second down at the halfway mark.
Yeah, for Toprak, he should still have time for another lap at the end of this session as well, but certainly not what he would have expected on that lap. Scott Redding doing a good job, though. He's on course for a new personal best, just about to come through the end of the third sector. We'll see if he's still able to improve his fastest time in this session, about 0.7 of a second off Jonathan Ray's time.
Redding then, as we say, into the final sector now. The long right-hander's coming up, where we saw Alvaro Bautista going down just a few short minutes ago. Then it'll be through turn 13 for Scott Redding, sliding his way out, followed on the circuit by Andrea Locatelli, the blue bike in the background of your shot, the number 55. But it's the 45 Ducati of Scott Redding that we're watching here. Half a second down on the fastest time after three completed sectors. Where's he going to finish up on this latest lap? Toprak Razgatlioglu ducking out from behind Jonathan Ray, who's rolled it off. as we approach the checkered flag. Raz Gadlioglu then sets a new personal best for this session, 1 minute 40.353. It's not enough to improve on his time from earlier on here today. The checkered flag has now fallen. I think Raz Gadlioglu just about got it over the line before the checkered flag fell, so he will have one more flying lap at the moment, tucked up behind Tati Mercado.
Yeah, it looks like Toprak got through just with 1 or 2 seconds to spare. Jonathan Rea, you can see a checkered flag behind, beside his name, so his session's done.
And Jonathan Rea sits fastest at 1 minute 39.671, the time to beat in the closing stages here. Scott Redding just set a 1:40.342, enough for him to go fourth fastest. So it's Rea, Rinaldi, Haslam, Redding. Bautista, despite his crash, of course, still sat up in P5 in this free practice too. Great effort from him. Rinaldi's final lap, he's unable to improve. So Rinaldi remains on a 1:40 flat, but it's still a great effort from Michael Ruben Rinaldi, second fastest in free practice too, and indeed, therefore, on the combined times. Leon Haslam makes his way to the line, can't improve on his final lap, 1.4 seconds down. So it's up to Locatelli now if anyone's going to improve later on.
Yeah, just seeing a host of riders losing their fastest times after the Bautista yellow flags. So the likes of Eugene Laverty, Vinales, and a few others have lost their fastest times. So Laverty now dropping down to 13th fast, about 3/10 of a second slower than Vandermark in this session.
He'll know nonetheless that he was well and truly on the pace of his teammate Michael Vandermark as Andrea Locatelli makes his way now through the final sector. 1 minute 40.6, his previous best time in this free practice too, and indeed here today as a whole. Locatelli crosses the line, but he loses time in the final sector. Toprak Raz Gadlioglu wasn't really on the pace on his final lap. It's a 1 minute 41.1. And the target time was, of course, a sub 1 minute 40. So Raz Gadlioglu won't be too perturbed, I don't think, about that. But it is Jonathan Rea and Michael Ruben Rinaldi who are very much the pace setters. Alex Lowe's here clearly still struggling with his wrist. And much as we anticipated and as we heard in an interview earlier on, but he still got in 17 laps during that session.
Yeah, good mileage being put in there by Lowe's. And what makes it worse for him with the hand injury is that right hand, so obviously that throttle hand brake, so you do need to have a lot of movement in that, but at least able to get a lot of miles in this session, and that's a good improvement on what we saw in this morning session when he was only able to do one run.
Jonathan Rea, though, fastest. Alex Lowe's teammate, 1 minute 39.671. We said he'd laid down a marker. That'll be a bit of a psychological demolition job. That was an excellent effort from Jonathan Rea.